Moving coil galvanometer. Moving coil galvanometer is a device which is used to measure a very small values of current. It is a very sensitive device. Let us see what is the principle of working of this device. This device works on the principle that when a current carrying coil is placed in uniform magnetic field, it experiences torque. That we have seen earlier also, same principle. So principle is, a current carrying coil placed in magnetic field experiences a torque, and torque is NIBA. Let's see what is the construction of this. In this galvanometer, there is a wire. This is a coil. You can say PQRS is a coil which is wound over a non-magnetic frame, and a non-magnetic frame, at the center of non-magnetic frame, a soft iron cylinder is kept. When we keep on by a winding over it, the other end of the coil is connected with a hair spring. The other second end of the coil hair spring is connected to the terminal, black terminal which you see outside. Red terminal where you connect positive terminal, one wire goes and connected to this screw which is placed right at the top of it. It is termed as torsion head. The coil is suspended with the help of phosphor bronze strip. Why phosphor bronze strip is preferred, or which material we should choose to suspend this coil in between two poles of a magnet? It is suspended in between two concave shaped poles like this. Coil is placed right at the center of the concave shaped poles, so magnetic field. Now coming back to the same point, why phosphor bronze strip is preferred, or what properties we should see before using this suspension wire, as a wire for the coil. Number one, it should have very high tensile strength. Number two, it should have high electrical conductivity. Number three, its temperature coefficient of resistance should be small. So there are few properties on the basis of phosphor bronze strip is chosen. Now, why concave shaped poles are chosen? You can place a normal two magnets also. Concave shaped poles are used because it produces radial magnetic field. And since coil is placed at the center and the magnetic field is coming out and entering into the south pole, all these points are lying where? At the circumference of a concave shape, that is circular shape. That's why when we keep coil at the center of this concave shaped poles, it experiences all the times maximum torque, does not matter with the angle of deflection. Wherever it deflects, torque will be maximum, because normal angle between normal unit vector and magnetic field will be. So let's see what second thing is, why soft iron cylinder is, another thing is why soft iron cylinder is used. Soft iron is ferromagnetic substance. and ferromagnetic substances have tendency to concentrate magnetic field in it. So when you place soft iron core at the center of non-magnetic frame over which the coil is wound, the maximum magnetic field can be linked with the coil. Lower end of the is connected with the hair spring. This also helps. Why connected with the hair spring? So when current passes through this coil, I will come to this point little later. When current is passed through this coil, how do we pass current? Connecting positive terminal here at red and negative terminal at black. When current is passed, this flows through the wire, then phosphor bronze strip, then entire coil, and then finally comes out to the spring and then goes out from the black terminal. The moment current is passed through the coil, it would experience torque. As a result, phosphor bronze strip get twisted. Because it is experiencing torque, coil also gets turned. Now question arises and think about it. What will happen when current is switched off through the galvanometer? When current is switched off, the coil with whatever angle is twisted may not recover its initial position by 100%. It will definitely not recover by 100%. It may recover by some value but not 100%. So what happens when coil experiences torque and gets twisted and turned? This hair spring develops restoring torque. So the moment current stops flowing through the coil, the restoring torque set up in the spring brings the coil back to its original position. So when we look at working and theory, torque experienced by the coil, torque is maximum NIBA, right? Restoring torque on twisting couple, restoring torque or twisting couple, restoring torque tau is equal to minus c theta, where theta is angle of twist and this c is called twisting constant. And its value is pi eta r raised to the power 4 over 2L. What is here in the value? Eta is modulus of rigidity that you have learnt in class 11th. R is the radius of suspension wire. And L is the length of the suspension wire, so you can calculate by using this formula. But in equilibrium, NIBA must be equal to C cos theta, C theta in the magnitude. So I is equal to C over NBA theta. This entire quantity is constant. So I is directly proportional to theta. That's how it works. Therefore, the larger be the current flowing through the galvanometer, more will be the deflection. And this constant is termed as, you can write this equation, I is equal to g theta, where g is called galvanometer constant. Right? Now two things we have to measure here regarding galvanometer. Number one is current sensitivity. So let's do current sensitivity. I keep this. Okay, I will write it again. Current sensitivity of galvanometer. It is defined as deflection caused in galvanometer by unit current. And as we know, I is equal to C over NBA theta. From this equation I can say theta over I is equal to NBA over C. So the current sensitivity IS depends on what factors? Very clearly mentioned in this formula. Number of turns, strength of magnetic field, area of cross section and torsion constant. Similarly, there is another quantity which we have to measure about galvanometer, that is called voltage sensitivity. VS. Right? Like current sensitivity, voltage sensitivity is also defined as deflection caused in galvanometer by unit volt. So this is theta over V, and as we know, V is equal to IR. You can have a look, this is IS, that you can put it as IS over R, that is NB over R, CR. Now from this formula, it is very much evident that if current sensitivity of galvanometer increases, voltage sensitivity will increase. Is that really so? Check it out. If I increase the number of turns, I am telling you one factor. So your answer of this question, if somebody asks you a question, when current sensitivity of galvanometer is increased, does it ensure that voltage sensitivity also increase? Answer is no. There is one denial. What is that? When we increase the number of turns in the coil, current sensitivity increases. But it is not essential with increase in number of turns in the coil, voltage sensitivity will definitely increase. Reason behind that is, by increasing number of turns, resistance of the coil also increases. So when resistance of the coil increases, N over R, one is occurring in numerator, another occurs in denominator. So ratio remains constant because it increases with the same ratio provided area of cross section has not been changed. Right? So it is not essential all the times when current sensitivity is increased, then definitely voltage sensitivity will also increase. Let's see about two more devices which you are using very frequently in the lab and you are very much familiar with it. Number one is ammeter. What is ammeter? It is a device which measures current, right? Ideally, an ammeter should have resistance equals to zero. for ideal emitter. Because it is a current measuring device, so as minimum as resistance will be there, that better result you can see. Fine. Now, how to convert galvanometer into ammeter? So, conversion of galvanometer into ammeter. To convert a galvanometer into an ammeter, we need to place a small value resistance in parallel to the galvanometer. This is called shunt resistance. So if I is total current passing through it, Ig will flow through the galvanometer and Is will pass through this shunt resistance. Since these two are connected, galvanometer resistance, I say G, is connected in parallel to the shunt resistance, therefore effective resistance you will find by parallel combination, that is 1 over G plus 1 over S. R effective is equal to GS over G plus S. Correct? Now voltage across both will be same because there is a parallel connection. So you can say IG into G, the galvanometer resistance is equal to IS into S. But I is equal to IG plus IS. So you substituting here. So IG into G is equal to I minus Ig into S. So shunt resistance is equal to Ig into G divided by I minus Ig. This is the formula from where you can calculate the value of shunt resistance in order to convert a galvanometer into a desired value of ammeter. What is where? This is a maximum value of current for which you want to design an ammeter. Ig is the value of maximum deflection current, which can a value of current which can show a maximum deflection. Now, if someone asks you, can I develop an ammeter with condition I is less than Ig? This is a conceptual question. If I is less than Ig, that is the max, I want to design an ammeter which could measure a current lesser than the maximum deflection current in galvanometer. Can it be possible? You can check. If I is less than Ig, then I, this denominator becomes negative. Therefore, shunt resistance becomes negative and resistance can never be negative. So this is not possible to design an ammeter with the condition I is less than Ig. So you can take this as a condition also, doesn't matter. You can consider, take it as condition or restrictions to design an ammeter, voltmeter and another device. Voltmeter device which measures a potential difference across two points. And as we know, for measuring potential difference, your resistance of a galvanometer or an effective resistance should be very large. So ideally it should be infinite, because when resistance is infinite, circuit is open and the potential difference becomes maximum, that is called EMF, right? So in order to conversion of galvanometer into voltmeter, To convert galvanometer into a voltmeter, you have to place a high value resistance in series. This is now your voltmeter. So R effective is easier to calculate, G plus R. Potential difference V is equal to IG into G plus R. So R, if you want to find, you can find V over IG minus G. This formula you can use to convert a galvanometer into a voltmeter of desired value.